Okay, so I have my pattern piece here, the main body of the pocket hoops. I've cut it on the fold, so when you open it out it'll be all one. And what I need to do is get my halfway point, so I've marked that with a needle just there. Sorry, not needle, pin, excuse me. So I know that's the halfway line. I'm just going to take this pattern piece off and cut it. I've added an extra 3 centimetres to the bottom of the piece. So I made a note earlier because after my mock-up I realised I needed a bit more on the bottom. These are just marking my boning channels, 1, 2, and then third one at the bottom. I've now opened my piece all the way out. You can just see it there. And I need to cut a slit down the centre, and I've already drawn my line that I needed, and I need the slit to stop there. So I've put a pin there and I'm just going to go ahead now and cut slit to that point. Okay, I've now opened up my pattern piece and I've cut my slit down the middle to about 18 centimetres. Okay, next we want to start marking out the boning channels. I start the first channel at the top, just slightly below where the slit finishes, so just 2 to 3 millimeters below that. My bias tape is 1.5 centimeters wide, so hence I put 2 pins here at each end for the width of my bias tape. Next we come to the bottom. And I know the seam allowance is 1.5 centimetres from the bottom. So I've just marked a pin there at the 1.5 centimetre point for my allowance. And then I know that the next boning channel will have to start just literally on that seam allowance line. And again, you want it 1.5 centimetres wide. So then I've worked out the width of that one, and I've done the same in the middle and to the other end. Then we need to get the halfway point for the middle boning channel. Okay, to do that, you start measuring from the first pin up where your seam allowance is, the 1.5 centimetres in, up to, near the top here, the last edge of your boning channel near the top, which has come to 24.5 centimetres on mine. So then what you need to do is half that, which is approximately 12.2-ish, because it's a bit tricky to try and half 24.5, but basically then it should give you your halfway point here, and then you just need to make sure that your middle channel is 1.5 centimetres wide. So the distance now roughly between each channel to the top of the next one is 10.5 centimetres. Bit tricky trying to film this while I'm holding the ruler at the same time, so it might look a little bit out, but there's your 10.5 centimetres between each channel. Before I do that, the measurement across the top measures approximately 50.5 centimetres, and the measurement across the bottom, it's about 62.5 centimetres. The next stage, I'm going to create a tiny baby hem by hand. It's slightly tricky, but not overly impossible, but you will run into issues at the corner here. So what you have to do is just turn it a little bit once. So just bear with me because it's kind of fiddly. I'll do a little bit at a time, it might be easier. And then just turn it again, hold it down. I'm finding this is the easiest way for me, but you might find doing it another way easier for you. Depending on your fabric as well will also depend how well it bends over. As you can see, I'm using this nice cotton check fabric that isn't too stiff and isn't too thin either. This is the tricky part here. So what you have to do is just get narrower and narrower to the end. You can see there's barely anything there. It's slightly tricky, and I'll show you how to deal with that in a moment. I've made a start on hand sewing my hem. As you can see, my hand sewing is not the best in the world, but I've got down as far as here, and this is where it gets a little bit fiddly. Tell you, small fingers really come in handy here. You've got to try and sort of keep it tucked under. I'm going to go over that again. Okay, the next thing I'm going to do is just put a whipping stitch around the bottom, but we will be putting a strengthening piece in a moment. You do want to go over it quite a few times. You can basically see what I'm doing, going up and then around. Basically doing a loop, but I'm doing each one quite a few times, and I'll continue to do that until I get to the other side around there. Okay. Next you need to reinforce the bottom of your slit. Even though you've gone over it with a whipping stitch, you'll want to make a little fill-in piece here just to help give it an extra strength and to stop it or prevent it from fraying or cutting in towards the middle a bit, if that makes any sense. So I've cut a little square here that measures 1¼ square. You then fold that square into a triangle. The next part is slightly fiddly, but not impossible, just requires a little bit of patience for a few minutes. You need to turn in the edges on your piece. And I've just started doing the one side here, and in a second I'll show you how to tuck your edges in. Okay, we'll start by the one end where I finished off the last bit of sewing. And I'll just anchor that down. And then I'm going to start going along. you get to this bit, you're going to have that on the outside, so you just need to bend it backwards a little bit. It's extremely fiddly, but it should look like that. Again, I'm just going to carry on and sew that in place. At the corners, I like to go down up and down a couple of times, so it just makes it a bit stronger. Almost like when you're on the sewing machine and you go backwards and forwards at the beginning of end. I just really want to make sure that those corners stay in. And then just finish it off like you'd finish off any hand sewing. I'll cut that off in a minute, but that's basically what it should look like. Do you want to sew down a little triangle piece? I started mine probably half a centimetre up from where the bottom of my slit is, just here, as you can see. I don't want it to be too much in the way of the boning channel, which starts about here. So really the only purpose of it is just to strengthen that bit at the bottom that I was telling you about earlier in the video. So I'm just going to go ahead now and hand sew that on around the edges. Now I've completed my triangle fill-in piece. And that completes that part of the pocket hoop so far. Okay, I'm going to be doing my bias tapes for my boning channels in a slightly different way to what you've probably seen other people doing in their videos. What I want to do is roll it round on the curve, so I'm using my leg as the curve. Because this needs to bend outwards eventually, this will help more than if you put it on the table and just put it on the flat. What this is doing then is it will help force the curve of your boning out a lot better, as opposed if you just did this on the flat and just pinned it straight like so. Later on when you come to put your curved piece of boning in, or cane, whatever you're using, it will have a little bit more difficulty. It will do it, but it will be slightly more difficult. So by doing this, I've just anchored a bit at the beginning. Just left a bit of an overhang there, and I've already put some other pins just to help as a guide where I'm going. Just bending it, rolling it around my knee, and without going through to your skin, just putting the pin in. I've actually caught my trousers there, like so. Just show you one more time, and you'll do this for all the tapes. So you're rolling it round your leg and just trying to grip that on the piece of fabric like so, and do that all the way around for the rest of your tape. When you come to the end of your bias tape, do not cut it. Go straight ahead and sew it down on the machine. Just a couple of millimetres in from the edge, like I've done on this bottom strip. And then when you've reached the end with your sewing and done both sides, then you can cut it. Okay, I've come to the end now of sewing my bias tape on. So just leaving a little bit there on the end, I can now cut it. And you'll do that for every single boning channel that you're sewing. I've now completed sewing on all my bias tapes for my boning channels. At this stage, it would be a good idea to measure how long you want your boning to be. And don't forget you'll have a 1.5 centimetre seam allowance in from both ends. So what you want to do, measure 1.5 centimetres in from your edge, that will be your seam allowance, and put a pin each side. Do that for the rest of your tapes. Then you want to measure in from that point on your pin to that point. On mine, this top tape comes to just under 50 centimetres. And of course, that because I've angled this out slightly on my pattern piece and it's not entirely straight, it will be slightly longer for all the others. Just apply the same principle and make a note of how long your boning's got to be when you come to put that in later. Next, you need to take your main piece of the pocket hoop, the large section here with the tapes on, and you need to find your halfway point at the bottom. So take your tape measure, measure from one end to the other. Mine comes to nearly 62.5 centimetres. And from there you need to half that figure to get your halfway point, and it should be in line with the centre here at the top. I use the point of this triangle as a good guide as well to help you. Once you've done that, you need to take this piece, which is going to form the bottom of your pocket hoops. It has a curved edge. It measures, just doing this approximately, I'm trying to hold this in video, 25 centimetres long. And about 26.5 centimetres long. This will depend on how big you want your pocket hoops to be. So these are just the measurements that I'm doing for my particular pocket hoops. You then need to find, by folding this piece in half, find the halfway point at the bottom. I've done this already, I've put my pin there, so you can just see a slight crease line where I folded it. That should be halfway between your two ends. This part is where it starts to get slightly tricky. You're putting a curved edge into a straight edge. But what you need to do is match up your centre pin on your base and centre pin on the bottom piece I've got here. They should match up. Then you want to pin those together. So make sure you've got this piece the right way out with your tapes, which will go on the inside. Otherwise you might end up with your seam on the wrong side. Now I've gone ahead and pinned the bottom piece on. You'll notice that I've put the pins facing outwards, as you can see here. This makes it a lot easier than pinning them in a straight line as you would do your sewing on a machine. This is where you can also make sure that it fits well. If it should be outside at one end, just by a few mils, you can just trim it back. But if it should be out quite a long way, then you've obviously made a mistake somewhere and you might need to just rejig it a little bit. But basically you were starting from that halfway point, pin outwards to that edge, and then coming back here, pin the two sides together all the way to the other end. Now remembering your seam allowance on mine is 1.5 centimetres, which should just sew literally a millimetre below that boning channel that you did earlier. And it's at this point where it's helpful to mark Not only coming in from your seam allowance, which is 1.5 centimetres in from the edge, but you also want to mark 1.5 centimetres in from this top edge. And you can see here, I've just put a little point. I've done the same the other end. So I'll just get this out just so you can see. So you go roughly about 1.5, and then 1.5 from the edge for your seam allowance. This is just to remind you when you're sewing to start at that point and finish at the other point. Do not sew from the top edge. This part is what's often missed out on a lot of other tutorial visits for these pocket hoops. They tend to skip this part and they don't show you properly what to do with the corners. I personally found following one or two of them tricky the way that they've done it, because they don't show this end how to do it properly. So I'm just going to go ahead now and sew that, and then I'll show you when it's finished. You can now see that the bottom piece has been sewed on. It might help if you sewed it on the side where your boning channel is, to make sure you don't go over the channel. You want the stitching just below, as I said earlier. And don't forget, this was your stop and starting point. So now the ends up to that point should be open. And the same for the other end as well. You'll see why in a moment that you don't sew up to the edges. But first of all, to allow this to bend, because it's quite a severe curve, you want to just do a few clips into it with the scissors, just to help it allow it to bend when you turn it the right side out. Here you can just see where I've clipped into it. As I've mentioned many times in my other videos, do not clip into your sewing line, otherwise you'll have to sew the whole thing again. You want to take your side piece. This is not quite square. One side measures on mine 28.5 centimetres high, and the other side measures just 27 centimetres. You should have the shorter distance match up with the distance on your bottom piece here that you just sewed on. This also comes to 27 centimetres. Just putting the pocket hoops on its side here, you should have the longer distance side coming from the top. So this would be the 20.5 and an 8 centimetres. Okay, before I actually sew the bottom edge on, I want to neaten off the top edge. So I'm just turning a little hem here along the top. And I'll just sew straight across, and that will be that part done. If you try and sew the side on first, then you'll probably have to stop around here to neaten off the top edge. So it's a good idea at this stage to get that done. I've now sewn the top hem down along the top edge, like so. Before I sew that on, I'm going to put ties on. It's at this stage that you can choose if you have ties or not, or if you just want front ties. I'm going to do front and back ties on my pocket hoops. You can see which way up I've got this. This is the outside with the split, and you're looking at the side piece with the boning channels. To make sure that my ties are put on quite strong, I've, by hand first, I tied on these ties 1.5 centimetres in, or just under, for my seam allowance. And then I've gone over them with the machine. This just helps make them a bit stronger and not so prone to getting pulled out of place later on. It is completely up to you at this stage. This is when you have to decide what exactly you would like. Just remember to sew your ties on the outside, not on the inside where the channel is, like so. You can see which way they're going in. Next, you want to sew your inner piece in. So first of all, you want to sew the bottom in, and remember to start again 1.5 centimetres in from each edge. Also, as you can see here, make sure you've got the inside of your hem at the top facing inwards, following the seam at the bottom. Sew up the side of the one section of your pocket hoops. Again, start 1.5 centimetres in from each edge on the corner. Now I've sewn up the other side, I'm just going to insert my boning. Into my channels. I've already done the bottom two. I start at the bottom because the bottom one is the hardest to do because it's got the most severe curve, and you can see I'm just threading it through the top here. The next part is a little bit tricky, and I required an extra pair of hands for this as I needed somebody to press on the top here. As you can see, there's a lot of tension now. So while I got hold of one mum, held it for me, I've pinned and hand tacked this in place along the other side, so it's a bit tricky to see. Again, you're starting at the corner. I've put a little dot here where to start my sewing, and it should meet up more or less, where you finish the other line of sewing along the bottom there. Otherwise, if you go in too far or too far out, you end up with a little hole in the corner. So just make sure as you go along that both the stitching at both the corners meets. Now I've turned my pocket hoops the right side out, like so. You'll want to neaten off the edges on your outside piece here. I've done mine by machine, but because of the bone near this end here, it'll let me go so far, so I could just leave that, or I can finish it off by hand if I wanted to. Do that for both of your pocket hoops. Next stage is to pleat the top. As you can see here, I've got 3 pleats going in that direction and another 3 pleats going in this direction, like so. In the middle, you create a little tiny box pleat. I've machined in place just along the top there, about 1/4 inch in, a line of stitching just to keep those pleats secure. Next, you need to measure. This is going to be a little bit tricky. You need to measure, basically, I would start from that end, but just for the camera, you can see that that's roughly 12 centimetres. You then measure the other side and get the measurement from there. Because then what you need to do is create a waistband. Here I have my piece for my waistband. So I've got my measurement from both sections, and I've added 1.5 centimetre seam allowance onto the ends. So mine come to about 26 centimetres long and about 8.5 centimetres high. This waistband eventually will be folded in half. But first of all, what we need to do is turn the ends of the waistband in. After you've hemmed the sides of your waistband, you need to start sewing it to the edge. Make sure you've got good side to good side. And I've sewn about half an inch in from the top. So when you turn it the right way out, it should look like this. Make sure that all your pleats are flat as you sew along, and it should work out. We're now going to turn the waistband under. I've gone ahead and done one of them already so you can just see what we're trying to achieve. And this other one I've made a start already. What you want to do first is along this top raw edge is turn it under about half an inch. So once you've turned that under, you can see your row of stitching here from earlier. You want to make sure this meets the edge of that stitching so you don't see the sewing. Okay, so we're just barely covering the bottom edge of that sewing and just putting some pins in place. Until you get to the end. Next we're going to do some little catch stitching in place to hold it down. You can machine it if you want to, but then you will have a sewing line come through to the other side. Okay, I'm just closing the waistband up, and to do this, taking a little bit from underneath and a little bit from underneath the waistband, just doing really, really tiny stitches. And that way you can get it to close up without having a line of stitches on either side. It's a little bit time consuming, but if you do it right, you shouldn't end up with any stitching coming through to the other side either. Just finish right the way to the end and then you'll be done. Now I've sealed my waistband, I need to thread some tape through the channels. We're just taking a bit of guess at the moment because I'm going to have it fitted in a minute to see where this tape has got it. Begin and end. I've just put some pins in place temporarily for now, just while it's being fitted. My tape is probably about it's 2 centimetres wide, but it does need to be narrower than your opening so you can thread it through.
Having fitted this now onto Tracy, I think I took quite a good guess there at this gap being about 6 inches, that's about 12 centimetres. This is for Tracy's fitting. And then you can tie up the ties at the back. You don't want them too tight, especially this one at the bottom. So just a bow to tie the three of them, and then Tracy, if you just turn around, that's okay, stop there. So you can see now that the panniers are square on to her body, so I think that's about in the right place. Turn to the front, Trace, then you tie up the front ties again, not too tight, and then where I've temporarily put a pin in this, that is where I will be cutting it off, and you can tie that with a bow. So what will happen then is where I've put the pins, we're now going to permanently sew the tape to the edges here and here and the other two at the back, so that the tape doesn't actually move inside your waistband and doesn't gather up.
These are my finished pocket hoops. Here you've got your pockets. And they also fold up quite nicely as well.